What's going on, guys? I'm Jed Eiser, the design engineer for Line Skis, here to talk to you about our new Sick Day series.
I'm Dylan Siggers. I'm a snow slider from Fernie, BC, Canada.
Hey, Andrew Whiteford from Jackson, Wyoming. I've got the new Sick Day series for 17-18. These skis we started developing a couple years ago, new core profiles, new shapes, and we're faced with the challenge of providing something that's really strong and stable and powerful, but can be playful at the same time. Through a lot of testing, a lot of different opinions, I think we've come together to have something that is surprisingly versatile.
So the focus on the new Sick Day series was really to preserve a lot of the sort of direction and feel of our previous Sick Day series and take weight out of the whole series. So we went about that by reconfiguring the core and the layup. The 114, 104, and 94 all have our carbon magic fingers.
The magic finger.
Magic fingers.
Carbon magic fingers are basically an array of thin spread toe carbon fibers. The carbon itself really makes the ski much more lively and responsive.
It's got a lot of power when you push into the edges. It really puts you back up onto your feet rather than wanting to slide out and wash out.
Scaling the overall taper angle in these skis was also really important. So the wider the ski is, the higher the taper angle is. And what that does is it gets you more surface area in the front of the ski. It makes the tips harder to bury in soft snow. And it's gonna make your tail sink a little bit more. So you get more surface area in the front of the ski, less surface area in the tail of the ski as you go up in waist widths.
You can always put your weight in the center of your feet and not have to compensate for deep snow or tough snow. You can be in the middle of the ski and it'll hold you in any big landings, big impacts.
For 2017, 2018, we also expanded the lineup of Sick Days. We're really stoked on how the ride feels, so we figured why not bring a narrower option in for the East Coast or just those days when you're hitting the groomers and slaying laps with your friends.
So to improve the hard snow performance of our skis, we reduced the amount of tip taper in both the 94 and 104, if you compare it to last year's 95 and 102. And that gets you more effective edge on the tip of the ski. It's easier to engage and more responsive.
The new shape of the Sick Day has a better edge hold, but still performs really well in softer snow and allows you to kind of get your tails out there when you want to slash a pow turn, slash some slush, or if you're going to rail a carve, you have that long edge to rely on to carve, slam your way back to the chairlift.
The other changes we made is the 114 uses a maple polonia core, which is a super lightweight core, which helps us shed weight out of that ski. It's an alpine ski, but I've been touring on that all year, and it's been unreal. The 94, 104, and 88 all use a full aspen core, so really solid and responsive. We've got full centered bases on all of our skis. We added tail protectors here and increased the amount of cap in our thin tip. For durability.
Every ski in the Sick Day lineup is made with capwell construction. It's a little lighter. It's a more durable sidewall construction. You're not left with rough edges or sharp right angle edges at all. It's nicer when you're holding them. Sick day!
So capwell is basically a constant height sidewall underfoot, and then it goes into a tapered sidewall into cap in tips and tails. And what that does is it really reduces the weight of the tips and tails along with our thin tip technology to keep the swing weight of the ski down. It makes the ski more durable and it makes the ski really solid and responsive underfoot.
The previous generations of the Sick Day were a great on-resort ski, but I've found that this is now my go-to ski in the backcountry at the ski hill.
All winter long, I was on the Sick Day 114. We were fortunate enough to get a lot of snow, and that I fell in love with. When I'm skiing in Jackson, I like to be able to charge, but every once in a while it's cool to slow down and get a butter or get creative, and so finding something that's got that versatility is really valuable.
It's a really reliable, predictable ski that works in every condition very well. I ski my Sick Days on deep pow days, slush days, icy days, and it's just a really reliable, strong, everyday ski that I think every person that likes skiing will enjoy.